I find the deep sea far from boring. I actually find it much more interesting than the shallow waters.
Every time we go out, we find something new. We learn a little bit more about these different animals. We find new animals every single time we go out.
With Maria as MERIAN, we are currently located on the southern side of Madeira Island. We are at a water depth of about 1,500 meters, lying above a submarine canyon that comes out from the island and drops off really quickly to the deep sea.
So the deep sea is so exciting because it is the last unexplored frontier. I'm Karen Osborne. I'm a curator at the National Museum of Natural History and the Smithsonian in Washington, D.C., and I am here to look at animals. There are animals out there that we don't know anything about. We spend a fair amount of time sorting them out and figuring out what's what, and then I like to get them straight under the camera so that we can capture what they really look like.
Working in the deep sea requires special equipment that can really deal with the strong pressure and the conditions that we find down there. I am Jan. I'm a scientist at GEOMAR Helmholtz-Zentrum for Ocean Research in Kiel. And here on board, I'm the chief scientist of this expedition. Behind the ship, we right now have the remotely operated vehicle Fokker. This is sort of a Swiss Army knife of marine research. It gives us a live view from down there. So we have live camera view transmitted via fiber optic cable to the ship. And then we also have samplers that can allow us to even sample jellyfish and very delicate organisms that otherwise would never come up to the surface.
Das Arbeitsdeck von der Ich nehme Geschwindigkeit auf und dann gebe ich euch Bescheid. Das Deck von der Brücke und wir sind auf Geschwindigkeit. Gerät kann zu Wasser.
Okay, 06.
Remotely operated vehicle requires a team of skilled pilots to operate the vehicle and then to capture and document the animals in the deep sea. I'm Henk-Jan Hoving. I'm a deep sea biologist, helping out with my expertise on deep sea biology from the water column to the deep sea floor. When I'm in the control room looking at the ROV video, I'm waiting patiently for that moment when an organism pops up that we have not seen or that we would like to capture or observe. And this moment creates a lot of joy. So I'm continuously looking forward to that moment because it's really exciting to see a deep sea organism that you're looking for and to be able to study it. And this is something we have been working towards now for several years, and here we are now. The pelagic ocean is the water column between the ocean floor and the surface. And when we consider the open ocean, this is a really enormous environment, a three-dimensional environment. It's actually the largest living volume, largest living habitat on the planet. We sample and observe these pelagic organisms and study their relationships as well as their diversity.
Yeah.
But also we try to understand what their role is, because ultimately these pelagic animals die and they fall onto the sea floor, and here they become prey, or they become food for deep sea bottom organisms. And this link between the water column and the deep sea floor is also one of my study areas and interests.
On this cruise Jellyweb Madeira, we have 22 scientists from 6 different institutes in 5 nations. Our focus here very strongly lies on the plankton, with a specific focus then on gelatinous plankton like jellyfish, tunicates, and chaetognaths, the delicate organisms traditionally not considered enough, and now we start to understand that they're actually really important in these food webs down there. Since my role is really coordination and management of the cruise, a lot of my job relates to organizing the daily plans for the next days, really saying which stations will we visit, which gears will we use, who is working at which times. Also, if there's any problems related to equipment or stations, that would be one of my tasks, to try to find solutions with the responsible scientists, and then also the interaction with the captain and the ship. Life on board a research vessel every time fascinates me. One reason is that all the distractions that we have in normal life kind of fall away. For 3 weeks that we're working in Madeira waters, it's like a machine. We have 22 scientists, little distractions, around the clock, 24-hour work. Somebody's always working, and so the amount of data and samples and science produced during this 3-week period is really mind-boggling to me.
Remotely operated vehicles have been used in deep sea biological investigations for a long time, mostly to study seafloor communities. But what's special on this cruise is that we're using the ROV in the water column. And the ROV pilots have been building dedicated sampling tools for sampling delicate gelatinous organisms like jellyfish and siphonophores.
Bring them on board, see what we find. Often their bodies are gelatinous and soft. And so I want to capture that really quickly. Put them under the camera, take shots from every angle we can, try to capture what we see so that everyone else can see it. Animals that live there have to be aware of everything that's around them. There's no place to hide. You're in the open ocean. It's like playing hide and seek in the middle of a football field. Right now we're studying how some of these animals see, and this helps us develop better cameras, view things in low light, even technology that's being used to study other planets. These animals have come up with solutions to a lot of problems that we face, maybe in slightly different ways, but they give us inspiration for developing new tools that we can use to solve problems that we have.
The deep sea is very relevant to us humans, first of all, because it's a carbon sink. Carbon from the atmosphere is taken up by photosynthesis of microalgae in the upper 200 meters of the water column, and then through various physical, chemical, and biological processes, this carbon ultimately sinks, is being processed in the deep sea, and ultimately it settles upon the deep sea floor where it is stored for millions of years.
It's just amazing to witness these systems, and I really hope that we can play our small part in then also helping to protect them in the future.
The ocean is one big, complicated web of organisms, and making those links between them is really important and is incredibly important to understanding how the ocean functions.
So I would love to be a sperm whale, because then I finally can see all those deep sea squids that are out there and observe them in their natural habitat and observe their all the different kinds of behaviors and tactics that they have to live in the deep sea. That would be my wish.
I know it's hard to do, it's hard to get at the deep sea, but I would encourage anyone and everyone to follow their interests if they want to know what's out there, and do some reading about what we've learned so far, and jump in and learn some of it yourself, and make some of these discoveries. Everyone can do it.
Based on these few weeks in the field, we will have years of samples and data to work with, and that, just from the pure scientific side, that's an amazing aspect of an expedition like this.